your shadows fall behind. When all the weight you carry is weighing on your mind, I'll be there to show you all the things you're missing and everything we go through. I'll be by your side, so let's run away to far away places, escape from this life we have known. Your eyes are new worlds to discover. Your heart is the place I call home. From this life we have known, your eyes are new worlds to discover. Your heart is the place I call home. Let's run away to far away places. We'll make a new life of our own. Your eyes are new worlds to discover. Your heart is the place I call home. Whoa.
Please be seated. We made it. We're here. Good afternoon and welcome to the 2020 Beulah Public Schools commencement ceremony. At the beginning of each year, I pick a few words that I want to help keep me grounded and focused as I navigate through a plethora of different issues that come my way. And every year for the last 4 years, I've picked the same word as part of my words, and that's perseverance. And perseverance is defined by doing something despite difficulty or delay in achieving success. And as I was laying in bed the other day, last Tuesday through Wednesday, didn't sleep, thinking of graduation, I could not help but think of a better word to describe the class, the Beulah Minor class of 2020. Individually and collectively, you have all continued to persevere during difficult times. You started school at the start of 9/11, and you finished during a global pandemic. And guess what? You're still here. You are not physically hurt, but you are likely emotionally exhausted. Your superintendent's exhausted. I don't blame you. What you've lost this past year, you will likely never get back. But what you haven't yet discovered in your lives should bring you great anticipation, excitement, and joy. And that is where I want to focus today. I want you to focus on today and every day, forward, joy. There will be moments in your life in which you find it very difficult to find joy. But please understand that these are just simply moments. Single moments are not defining. They are simply one chapter, one paragraph, one page, or one sentence in your book. And I'm a firm believer that if you are brought to it, you will be brought through it, and you will be better because of it. You being better, don't let society get the best of you. In the world of fake news, real news, you get to choose, but don't abuse. And what I mean by that is this: empathize instead of criticize. Lost in our world today is the ability to disagree with somebody, but continuing to be respectful. Don't succumb to this type of behavior. Be a status quo shaker, conformity breaker, and a difference maker. And that you've done already. You've been a difference maker in the lives of so many. Your family, your friends, your teachers, administrators, everyone around you. You've brought joy to Minor Nation, and you've taught us all to persevere during difficult times. On behalf of the entire school district, I say thank you for that, and congrats to all of you on this very special day.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for being part of our special day, whether in person or behind a screen. Hopefully, I cried enough writing this that I won't cry during it. I know that we are graduating under less than ideal circumstances, but I don't want to talk about COVID-19 today. I want to talk about three things that we all possess: our mind, our heart, and our attitude. First off, our mind. It's what surprisingly got us all here today. I'm looking at you, Mole. Through our years of schooling, our minds have been filled with more knowledge than we probably need. We know, or should know, slope formula, how to write in MLA format, and that the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. All of us know we've forgotten the steps in photosynthesis if we ever knew them in the first place. Along with that, we have also learned valuable life lessons. We learn to say we are sorry, take our hats off while we eat, and that drugs are bad. Our minds are not only filled with equations and lessons, but with ideas and dreams. Whether that be to cure cancer or to build the best derby car, I know that each one of you has a dream that you wish to fulfill. This is our chance. We are the next generation of good ideas and big dreams. So put your mind to it, go out there, and get it done. Next, our heart. I'm not talking about the one that keeps us all alive. I'm talking about the one that fuels our passions and feelings. Our class knows what it's like to have a broken heart. Individual classmates even had shattered ones. When a heart breaks, you have to patch up the cracks. Our class patched our broken heart with strength and unity. And I don't mean to be the bearer of bad news, but there are more heartbreaks to come. You will fall, you will make mistakes, and it might break your heart a little, but you have to keep patching the cracks. Get up again and push through. The more heartbreaks you overcome, the stronger you will be. Don't let it defeat you, but embrace it and let it help you grow. At times, we have been dealt a bad hand, but through that, I have seen all of you grow into strong, loving individuals. Lastly, our attitude. Your attitude is one of the few things that you can control. How you look at life greatly influences what you get out of it. A very wise man, otherwise known as Dooley, has this equation hung up in the weight room hallway. Event plus reaction equals outcome. We have a choice every day to choose how we act and respond to the events in our life. You can't change your past, predict your future, or change what others think of you, and that's okay. Because you can learn from your mistakes, work hard for your future, and create your own identity. I know that at this point in our lives, things look scary and intimidating, especially given our unique circumstances. But I encourage all of you to look ahead with positivity and enthusiasm. You are about to start one of the most exciting times of your life. Be motivated, be optimistic, and be open-minded. As you go forward, use your mind, heart, and attitude to steer you towards success. The ideas in your mind are strongly influenced by the passions of your heart and driven by your attitude. I know that each one of us will do great things in whatever we choose to do. If you take anything from this speech, let it be this. You control your own destiny with the tools that you have been given. The knowledge of your mind, the strength and love of your heart, and the motivation and enthusiasm of your attitude. I would like to thank my family for always pushing me to do my best and comforting me when I fail. Thank you to the teachers and faculty that have helped us learn and grow through every stage of life. And thank you to my friends who have grown into family over the last 12 years. Thank you for the memories we made in the classroom, the nights we stayed up laughing, and the many, many times we drove around the streets of this small town because, frankly, there's nothing else to do. I know that we're thinking about what could have been, but now we must think about what will be. Somehow, we made it. Congratulations to the class of 2020. You will always have a place in my heart.
Good afternoon. We're here. It's been a long road, and I'm excited to be standing here with you guys today celebrating. There's a lot of things in doubt this year, but I'm so happy to reach this day and be able to celebrate with you guys. At this time, I have the distinct honor to publicly recognize our Beulah High School honor students, and we're going to do something a little different this year. Graduates, as I call your name, just stand and remain standing so we can recognize you guys for your achievements. At this time, I will begin with the students who have earned a presidential award, which consists of earning a 90% or above cumulative grade point average for their high school career. Each graduate will receive a certificate and pin signifying that the student has received the President's Education Award. Alexis Foss. Michael Feist. Kane Kaiser. Spencer Melmer. Devin Askham, Hope Schlender, Corey Reeb, and Dayton Fiddler. Give them a round of applause. Thank you. Now we'll recognize our students graduating with honors. In order to be recognized as graduating with honors, each student must have a cumulative grade point average of 93% to 95.99%. Each graduate will receive a certificate and a pin signifying that the student has received the President's Education Award and a medallion from the Beulah Public School District. Cassidy Nelson, Evan Beer, Tristan Miller, Clay Olson, and Kale Voigt. Give them a round of applause, thank you. Thank you. Next, we will recognize our students graduating with distinction honors. In order to be recognized as graduating with distinction honors, a student must have a cumulative grade point average of 96% to 97.49%. The graduate will receive a certificate and a pin signifying the recipient of the President's Education Award, a medallion from the Beulah Public School District, and a trophy signifying their achievement. The following graduates have earned this award: Rachel Sperry and Matea Dostal. Thank you. Finally, we will recognize our students graduating with highest distinction. In order to be recognized as graduating with highest distinction, a student must have a cumulative grade point average of 97.5 or above. The graduate will receive a certificate, a pin signifying them as a recipient of the President's Education Award, a medallion from the Beulah Public School District, and a trophy signifying this achievement. The following graduates have earned this award: Camille Clindworth, Tia Horning, Christiana Schmidt, and Emily Wenning. Congratulations to all of you on this achievement. It's a lot of hard work, and we're very proud of you. You're already seated, so. Next we'll have, I'll get organized here, Tia Horning with her address. Thank you.
Class of 2020, congratulations on pushing through hard times to finally reach the finish line, our graduation day. I know we were all looking forward to senior skip day, but we may have taken it a little too far this year. But now it is the day we have all been waiting for since we walked in high school freshman year, counting down the days until we could finally get out. It has finally come, and we have proven that hard work and determination does pay off in the end. We must continue to always look forward to the future, but also enjoy the journey to get there. From elementary school, we have changed from walking miles on the track every Friday for a plastic foot to driving circles around every Friday night with your friends. During this challenging moment, during coronavirus, it has really turned our normal lives upside down. You can't take for granted, and you have to cherish every moment. Not only has it affected our class of 2020, North Dakota, and the USA, but it has also spread to the entire world. We will be stronger after this crisis and know how to fight through situations when the going gets tough. Even though it may seem like the pandemic is never ending, just remember that it is a moment in time, and it will definitely be a memory that we will never forget, just like the first time you fell down the stairs in the high school. It has built character and defined who we are. Who we are is a group of students who can achieve the impossible if challenged. I guess you could say we work best when put to the test, and we never give up. As we finish this chapter of our lives, we will continue on to the next chapter. It could get stressful and scary at times, but just look at what we have gone through, and it won't seem as bad or as big of a task asked of you. I know from my past athletics that when the going gets tough, just dig a little deeper, and you will succeed at what you are working towards. Even if it was your coach making you run sprints until you're about to puke. You have thought about quitting, but you never gave up because you knew the extra work would pay off, whether it was beating a team that was supposed to be better than you or making it to state. Some of you want to be a nurse, lawyer, or farmer, and you will be successful if you apply yourself and stay on task. You will have some setbacks, but that is life, and it doesn't take much to refocus and get back on track. 1 Peter 1:6 says, "Be truly glad, there is wonderful joy ahead of you. I wish each one of you a bright future, but most of all, happiness." In closing, I'd like to thank my teachers for putting up with me and pushing me throughout the years to always work hard and achieve my goals. They are the reason why I am giving this speech today in front of you. I would have not been able to achieve this without them. I would also like to thank my family for shaping me to be the person I am today and for always supporting me in my activities I have been involved in over the years. They have been by my side each step of the way. Lastly, I would like to thank my friends and classmates who have been a part of my life. I know we did not get to spend the last few months of school together like we hoped, and today might be the last time we get to see each other, but I'm very thankful to have spent my high school career with these wonderful people in this room and the ones looking down on us. You will always have a special place in my heart. Class of 2020, we are the future, so go get it.
Here we go. Beulah Public School Board members, these students before you have met the requirements as set forth by the North Dakota Department of Instruction, as well as the requirements of Beulah Public Schools, and are therefore recommended for graduation. Graduates, please come forward when your name is called to receive your diploma. Devin Jacob Askham. Evan James Beer. Matea Lois Dostal. Michael Tad Feist. Dayton Patrick Fiddler. Alexis Brandy Foss. Brady Michael Gunch. Tasia Ann Horning. Tia Shaylee Horning. Kane Joseph Kaiser. Camille Henry Clindworth. Bradley Joseph Murphy Kraft. Jonah Reed Larson. Thomas Robert Larson. Robert Jace Lee. Hunter Lane Lind. Austin Galen Meyer. Spencer Hayden Melmer. Tristan Scott Miller. Colton Robert Mole. Cassidy Joy Nelson. Clay Matthew Olson. Jordan Thomas Rakes. Austin Lane Richardson. Wardrobe malfunction. Garrett Glenn Rossborough. Corey James Reeb. Hope Ali Schlender. Christiana Marie Schmidt. I didn't know that one. I'm going to have to use that. Tucker Scott Soland. Rachel Lynn Sperry. Cade Timothy Steffen. Cody Allen Tweeter. Eric Michael Lawrence Euland. Kale Donald Voigt. Briley Madison Weigum. Emily Faith Wenning. Graduates, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the Beulah High School class of 2020. Thank you.